Prefabricated houses, as opposed to houses built conventionally from the ground up, have a history that goes back at least 175 years, when some of the first were shipped out to Australia and South Africa from England. One of the largest programmes of prefabricated house building was in the United Kingdom, following the destruction of World War II. Over 150,000 were constructed in various designs, typically two-bedroom units, with around 60 square metres of floor space. They came pre-decorated, with a fitted kitchen and bathroom connected to a service unit. They were made to a much higher specification than the houses they replaced. They cost in the region of £1,200 to build, which was more than a conventional brick-built house at that time. They were expected to last only 10 to 15 years, although some are still occupied today, 70 years later. Today, similar construction techniques are widely used for temporary buildings, such as site offices, and for mobile homes. For permanent housing, people look to prefabricated construction either for style and quality, for example in the German Hofhaus, or for low cost. A prefabricated house might cost €40,000, excluding the land. A similar, conventionally built house might cost €60,000. The SML House, SML standing for Small, Medium, Large, is a demonstration project by the Universidad Cardinal Herrera in Valencia. This adds a third factor, flexibility. The idea is that the building can change in size to match the changing needs of the occupants. The configuration we're about to see is a medium design, a 74 square meter house with kitchen, bathroom, living dining area, home office and bedroom, together with a service module and an enclosed patio area. The SML house could be made larger by adding more modules or smaller by removing modules. The six modules were prefabricated at a size that makes them suitable for road transport. A metal base has been pre-assembled. This allows for any variations in level on the site and also creates a service area underneath the modules.
Una de las principales ventajas de la casa es empezando por su implantación. Está pensada para que se pueda ubicar en cualquier sitio que sea irregular, que el suelo no tiene que estar uniforme. Entonces, como veis, la cimentación está formada con unos grandes tornillos, muchos pero grandes, donde puede coger las irregularidades del terreno. Está también pensada para que carguen muy poquito peso, es decir, que el terreno pueda ser como con muy poca carga, pueda apoyarse con poca tensión. Bien, la casa también está hecha en módulos que se pueden transportar con un camión, un poquito especial con un camión, y que pueda ubicarse con estas piezas, se pueda crecer o reducirse al mínimo espacio o ir creciendo según las necesidades del proyecto. Una vez montados los módulos, en muy poco tiempo, habitualmente una hora, hora y cuarto por cada módulo, el módulo ya es completamente estanco, puede funcionar con inclemencias meteorológicas cualquiera. Y bueno, son un poco las primeras ventajas, ¿no? Que es posible adaptarse la casa a cualquier terreno, irregular que sea. Otras ventajas es la orientación. Podemos orientar la casa con esta forma de trabajo, orientarla como queramos, para que trabaje la forma más eficaz, la solar térmica. Y entonces que la casa sea completamente autosuficiente, que no necesitamos ningún tipo de conexión eléctrica. Y para verlo, lo vamos a implantar en este momento que está implantada, no tiene ningún tipo de conexión, y vamos a hacer que la casa sea completamente funcional.
A key objective was to demonstrate that the house could generate enough electrical power to be self-sufficient, so there are photovoltaic panels on the roof of each module, and also on walls that face towards the sun. By following a number of passive house principles, including orientation, thermal mass, solar protection and gain, as well as domotics to minimise power consumption and to schedule peak electrical loads to coincide with peak output, the SML house is a net producer of energy. The enclosed courtyard patio acts as a passive energy saving system by reducing the effect of solar radiation on that side of the house, as well as providing privacy. It is a flexible structure that can be extended to fit the number and layout of the modules that form the SML house. As regards materials, these were selected on the basis of sustainability as well as functionality and appearance. The SML system is mostly wood. As well as being fully recyclable, this greatly reduces the weight of the building. Prefabrication and pre-decoration of the modules reduces the amount of waste created in the construction. It also allows extensive use of unskilled labour, in this case, students. The service module comes ready plumbed and wired. Pipework and service units are quickly installed and connected. In summary, comparing the SML system with a conventional house, the amount of solid waste from the construction is reduced by 75%. The total time for construction, including prefabrication of the modules, is reduced by 60%. The transport and water requirements are reduced by two-thirds when compared with conventional construction. And the lightweight construction uses 40% less material.
Este proyecto va vinculado a desarrollos tecnológicos de empresas, su capacidad de difusión social, es decir, no solo actividad universitaria, empresas, sino brindarlas a la sociedad, que la sociedad sea capaz de entender el comportamiento de estas viviendas. ¿El comportamiento en cuanto a qué? En comportamiento en cuanto a su capacidad de ser respetuoso con el medio ambiente. La línea básica fundamental es que hoy en día estamos en un entorno donde la construcción no está sostenida bajo premisas de respeto medioambiental y por lo tanto los futuros actores profesionales de todo el sector profesional en torno a la edificación tiene que ser consciente de el uso de materiales eficientes, el uso de materiales sostenibles, integrar tecnologías renovables.